Hello, my dear friends. Thank you for watching this blog. Today, as always, we'll try to briefly and essentially understand what is happening in Ukraine and around Ukraine. The main story of this week, of course, the presentation by the General Prosecutor's Office of Ukraine of a suspicion of committing high treason to the leader of political party Opposition Platform for Life, Viktor Medvedchuk, was discussed. And it was not possible to put Medvedchuk in jail by a court decision on a measure of restraint in the form of house arrest. He will actually be isolated from political and public activities. Let me remind you that Medvedchuk is accused of cooperation with Russia Federation in mining of minerals in the Crimea Shelf and disclosing data concerning the location of armed forces of Ukraine. All these charges will be difficult to prove in court, which is likely to last for several years. But such accusations create a serious political problem for this political force and isolate it from the neutral part of electorate, making the image of this political force toxic. At the same time, it was not only Medvedchuk who had problems with the authorities. About 10 companies and persons associated with the mayor of Kyiv, Vitaly Klitschko, have been searched by law enforcement agencies last week. The mayor of Kyiv demonstrates ambitions and readiness to compete to the presidency during the next presidential election. And in this regard, he has an aggressive conflict with presidential office. The attack of the authorities on the head of the Constitutional Court also continues. Mr. Tupitsky was removed from his post. He was also searched by the law enforcement officers this week. The president is trying to gain control over the Constitutional Court. Also, a few days ago, several audio recordings were made public, potentially to discredit Petro Poroshenko. All this process allows us to talk about the course of the Zelensky team to suppress the political and economical opposition. Moreover, the head of the National Security and Defense Council, Mr. Danilov, recently announced that the authorities have a draft bill that will allow them to punish all the oligarchs. The provisions of this bill are still unknown to the public, but the list of potential oligarchs are already beginning to be published by the media, which looks like blackmail. The concept of oligarch in general is difficult to define. In Ukraine, we have 8 persons who have assets more than $1 billion United States dollars, and more than 150 people who have assets more than 100 millions of United States dollars. And practically all of them take part in politics to one degree or another. They support certain politicians because they cannot protect their property in any other way, because the judicial and law enforcement system are ineffective and corrupted. So this initiative looks like a game with the public sentiments and imitation of the struggle with the oligarchs before the eyes of Western partners. Moreover, the general socio-political situation in Ukraine remains tense. The authorities are going to once again raise the cost of house service, and the Russian Federation is turning military pressure. Thank you for watching this blog. I will be happy to answer your question in the comments. Bye.